Seo Sung Jae of Korea, up against the new world number ones, but number three seeds here, Fajar Alfian and Muhammad Rian Ardianto of Indonesia. Well, we were down to five seeds by quarterfinal stage of the men's doubles. Six different nationalities. There was two pairs from Indonesia and two from China. One of the Chinese pairs is already through to the final, as you can see. Only two seeds at semi-final stage. The seed in the bottom half of the draw, the World Championship bronze medalists, they lost. And now Alfian and Ardianto, the beaten finalists from last year at this event, are going to try and reach a second consecutive final here in Kuala Lumpur.
Men's double semifinals. Kang Min Yook, Seong Siu Jae, Korea, versus Fajar Alfian, Mama Rian Ardianto, Indonesia. Kang Min Yook, now we present Kang Min Yook, Seo Seong Jae, Korea.
The Korean pairing, unseeded Kang Min Hyuk and Seo Seong Jae. Seo Seong Jae, the left-hander. And they, like the pair, already in the final tomorrow, are playing their first ever Super 1000 semi-final. Fajar Alfian and Muhammad Rian Ardianto. Well, when they reached the final of this event last year, this event was a Super 750, and now it's gone up to a Super 1000. So they too will be looking to reach a first Empire final at Super 1000 level.
Service judge, Chiaki Mayazaki,
eight finals
Japan.
Last year. No wonder they've become the new world number ones. The seeding done for this event before they reach number one in the world, hence they're only seeded three. This will be a second meeting between these two pairs. The only previous occasion was at the Korean Open last year, and Kang and Seol went on to win the title there. Three games, as you saw.
Choose this side, the right side. They choose the right side. Who will serve?
Cheetan Bart from Australia or our umpire. Having conducted the toss of the coin, Alfian and Ardianto have chosen ends and will start the near side of the court. Pair did play one Super 1000 event last year, the Indonesian Open, where they had success in the second round, beating Gideon and Sukumulyo, the number one seeds. Kang Min Hyuk is 23, or so he'll turn 24 next month. This is the older of the two, Seo Seong Jae, who's 25. And he has been as high as 7 on the world ranking with his former partner, Choi Soo-gul. As a combination, they're playing off their career high of 18, and looking at their results, well, in the first round, a pair promoted from the reserve list. And then they beat the Olympic champions, Li Yang and Wang Qilin. And then in the quarterfinal yesterday, beat the two-time former champions, Muhammad Hassan and Hendra Setiawan, in three games. So to Fajar Alfian, who is 27 from Bandung in West Java. 175 is about 5'9". And it's their third consecutive week as world number ones. Lost in the final last year to Hoki and Kobayashi. Muhammad Rian Ardianto will turn 27 next month. So they are looking to reach a ninth final in 11 months. They had European opposition in the first and second round. All of their matches, as you can see, went the full distance. The Popoff brothers from France in the first round, then the European champions, Lamsfuss and Seidel. And then in the quarter final, the 2021 World Championship bronze medalists, Yu Xin and Team PE. So as I was telling you, our court officials from Australia and Japan. Indonesian coaching bench. Ariana Miranats on the left as we looked at them. And Ribanagi.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Fajar Alfian and Mohammed Rian Ardianto, Indonesia. And on my left, Kang Min Hyuk and So Sung Jae, Korea. Kang Min Hyuk to serve. To Mohammed Rian Ardianto, love all, play.
So the unseeded Koreans, the left and right handed partnership in the all black kits, far end of the court. And the semi final underway against last year's beaten finalists.
One love.
And Ardianto. I've been very impressed by the Korean pair so far. I watched their second round match against the Olympic champions and also their quarter final yesterday against the two-time winners here at the Malaysian Open. The same as I watched the Koreans. Role at the back and the front, and he felt that playing with So Seung Jae, who was, he felt very, very competent at the back of the court with his attacking play, that he had more freedom to go to the net and really challenge on the front court.
Six, three.
results timed it. But the fact that he read the reply, anticipated it well, will make the Indonesians think twice about playing back there again. Good serve out wide. Look at that. Oh, it's just wide.
By six.
There's just enough pace on that drive return of the smash. Kang at the front of the court.
9-8. That is over.
Well, there's a challenge here from the Indonesians.
One challenge remaining. Service over. 10-9. Play.
Advantage. stepping forward. Point at the moment. Shetty. I have a feeling we're going to have a similar situation here with the battle between Kang and Alfian. Opportunity to get themselves on the attack. The interception from Kang at the front of the court was the one that did the damage. Oh, that's well judged. Well done. Oh, there's a challenge from the Koreans. Right. I think both pairs have got one challenge remaining. Because Alfian and Ardianto thought that a smash had gone long their side of the court, and it was judged to be miles in. So they were unsuccessful on that. Possibly have two challenges left. Indonesians into the lead on a run of three straight points.
Service over. 16-4.
Look at that. 16. That's clever.
Alfian and
Mohamed Rian Ardianto, 21-18.
18 minutes needed for that opening game. Role is the left-hander Sosiang Jay.
20 seconds. Second game, level.
So one game to the good, the new world number ones, Alfian and Ardianto. Service error.
Service over. 1-4.
Oh, goodness. Well, he had to play three extra shots from when he should have won the rally. But he didn't because of the defensive qualities of the Koreans. Look at that, how on earth did he get that back? That change of pace. Yeah. Koreans have somehow got to get themselves on the attack.
Service over. 3-4.
And I'm not sure they're playing it back to the net when Alfian is standing waiting there. Is the way to try and achieve that. Well, when they do get the opportunity to attack, the Koreans have got to make it count. And he's not been able to produce the same sort of form, Seo Song-jae, that I've witnessed earlier in the week. Not so far, anyway. Too big a swing from Kang. When you're at the net, you don't have time for a big swing. Got to be a short, sharp movement of the racket head. Nice. It was that delightful change of pace with the angled drop shot from Ardianto. Set the rally up.
7-4.
And notice how Alfian got out of his partner's way so he could just move forward to play the final smash, the winning shot. 4 straight points.
Colts.
Double hit.
Service over. 5-7.
This time from Fajar Alfian.
Service over, 8-5.
That's a very good serve and an even better return.
Service over, 9-6.
Swung at the shuttle, missed it. And it landed in. Yeah. The attacking play is just too potent at the moment from the Indonesians for the Koreans to deal with.
10-8.
Point advantage. And Alfian and Ardianto just 10 points away from a ninth final in the last 11 months. I think it is. Able to do in the opening game. Good serve and hunting the third shots and then controlling the rally. Nice play from Kang. Form the left-hander of earlier in the week. Perhaps it's because he's not been allowed to find the form. Perhaps the Indonesians just aren't giving him the time. Yeah, it was fast back to that.
Service over, 11-13.
This is the best that Alfian and Ardianto have played all tournament. 11. And taken the full distance, three games in their three previous matches. But you want to find your best form at the latter stages of the tournament, as long as you get through. This is a nice little cushion, 5-point advantage. Totally deceived on the flick serve, saucy young Jake. Interception by Ardianto.
There.
And presence of mind to just play the little acute soft angle. Good for Kang. My goodness, mate.
Service over. 14-17.
three points away from a second consecutive final here at the Malaysian Open. The Indonesians play so well. And with that delightful, delightful shot, with it comes five match point opportunities. Opportunity. And they've done it. A second consecutive final at the Malaysian Open for Fajar Alfian and Mohamedourian Ardianto. 42 minutes for their victory over Kang and Siu. And for the Indonesians, an incredible ninth final in the last 11 months. Well, the first match that they've won in two straight games. 21-18, 21-17. Here in Kuala Lumpur this week. Well, they were very positive from the start, looking to attack. And their favoured formation, as they finish the match with Ardianto at the back of the court, playing the powerful attacking shots and wonderful angles. And Alfian at the front of the court today was superb. So they take leave of center stage. What a semi-finals day it's been. Confirmation of the scoreline: Fajar Alfian and Mohamedourian Ardianto are beating Kang and Seoul 21-18, 21-17. 21-18, 21-17 in 42 minutes. So as they take selfies with some of the fans, we now know the order of play for tomorrow's matches. We know the lineup, of course, and we'll be starting with mixed doubles. It's a repeat of last year's World Championship final. Sheng Shiwei and Wang Yashiong going for a fourth consecutive Malaysian Open title together. They're up against the Olympic bronze medalists Yuta Watanabe and Arisa Higashino. Then it'll be women's doubles and Chen Qingcheng and Zha Yifan, reigning world champions and former winners here. They're in their third Malaysian Open final. They'll be up against the unseeded Baekar Na and Liu Lim. Then it will be women's singles and the number one and two seeds, Akane Yamaguchi against Ang Se-young. One of them will win a first women's singles title for either Japan or Korea in the Open era here at the Malaysian Open. Our fourth final of the day will be men's singles, and the reigning world and Olympic champion and defending champion here, Victor Axelsen, in his 11th Super 1000 tournament final and ninth consecutive Super 1000 final, up against the unseeded Kodai Naraoka in his first Super 1000 final, in his first Super 1000 tournament. That's quite remarkable. And then we'll finish with men's doubles and the new world number ones, Alfian and Ardianto, in their ninth final in the last 11 months, are up against Lang and Huang from China. So much to look forward to. Finals tomorrow start at 1 p.m. local time, 0500 GMT. And in the meantime, from all of us here, and especially from me, Jill Clark, we'll see you for the finals tomorrow. Bye for now.